Hello, welcome back to Let's Play Skyrim Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari.
My favorite drinking buddy.
Yeah.
Let's get some mead.
Why don't we just hang out here? Let's get out of here. Few things since the last Let's Play. Well, I took a strength potion and went back to Whiterun, sold my stuff. Yeah, I was overloaded once I got back to the city. So what I normally do is just walk really slow, like I have to, and then use whirlwind sprint to go woo through the city. And a courier came up, and because I was doing that, you caused quite a bit of stir in Whiterun when you demonstrated the power of your thumb, not everyone, etc., etc. You should turn your attention to Northwind Summit. Yeah. It's another word wall, obviously. So, because I was shouting through Whiterun, I got another one of those things. Let's see. Some miscellaneous. So it's over here. It's by Shorestone. Pretty much, it's on the way to Riften. So, I'll probably go there before Riften or afterwards. Whenever I find myself in that area. Another thing that I want to try out. I added a mod for... Where's your tents? Where's all your tents?
There is much beauty in this place.
Do you seek to make a purchase? Khajiit's wares, if you have coin.
The roads of Skyrim lead to many dangers.
Need something?
May your
road
lead you to warm sands.
I found
this
guys.
One needs something?
I found these guys once before. I don't think I've ever recorded it here.
Take a look.
Take a look. I love these guys. So yeah, they sell the basic things. You get a good amount of lockpicks here. Potions. I don't really need any more. I'll take a plentiful healing, sure. Shock suppression. Neat. Just looking at what he's got, obviously. Right.
I hope that you will come to do business with us again.
I don't know what the tents went to. I installed a convenient horses mod. I updated a couple other mods. I'm using this blade by now, by the way. I took my sword of fiery doom or whatever I call it. I put that in my home for a future follower to use maybe. Ooh, this is much better. It takes 25 points of frost damage and 50 points of stamina damage, so this is pretty good. The only thing is, out of any weapon I have, this uses up charges really quick. I don't know if I showed you guys. I might have used it the last couple times. Who's this? The doggy? Ardwen?
Yes.
Hello.
We're traveling to the Shrine of Kinnereth in Whiterun. I hear the Gildergreen is more beautiful than ever since it's been restored.
Yes.
They say that eating the fruit it bears will add years to your life.
Possibly. That's it.
You want something from me?
Not really.
All right then.
You're almost there. Just keep going. There's nothing else to say to these people. Okay. Well, first of all,
got the fleetest steeds in all of Skyrim.
To activate this mod, you need to have a horse.
Suppose so. Got one all saddled if you've got the coin. You've got the deal. It's the one with the saddle.
Yeah, it's the only horse there.
Right. Gal like you needs a war horse, I reckon. Aye.
Well, let's get to get on it first. Bound key mode. I'm not going to use all the, convenient horse update faction relations. Get back here.
Only thing better than riding a swift horse is riding a swift horse over the enemy.
Pretty much. Okay, so you get this horn.
Ysmir's blessing on you.
This is part of the mod.
Mm-hmm.
Now say you're far away. And or blind. Where's my horse? I can't find my horse, so... That thing's still working. Horse call. And convenient horses. But let's check this out first. Actually, no. I wanna... Favorite and favorite. So, yeah. Conveniently. Conveniently. Over here. So, say you don't know where your horse is. Say maybe the horse isn't over there. Maybe it's all the way... Like, on top of that mountain or something like that. Because you left it there and you forgot where you put it. Something like that. Ta-da! And yeah, I didn't jump or anything. It does that automatically, but yeah. So, I know I've barely used horses. I used it once to escape from Markarth. 98% complete. Okay, so... I haven't even tried this yet. Okay, am I supposed to get off first? Yeah. Okay, so... Control settings... When should fast speed dismounting be used? Fast dismount. Not about always. Combat override. Disable multi-tapping while in combat. To maximize response time. Okay. This is my SKSE version. Player's horse. Okay. Default. Yeah, I don't want to really cheat on any of this stuff. Just showing you guys. You can add stamina, health, invulnerable, off. Horses will follow their owners except when sneaking or in specific locations. I have follow off, it'll just wait for me. Return. So friendly, neutral. Yeah, how about they not attack my horse? That'd be cool. Friendly factions. Hold on a sec. Miscellaneous. Game display control mode every time a game is loaded. Store items. Okay, this is what it does. It's basically an inventory for your horse, but it doesn't store the items technically not in the horse, but it's in a like a container that no one can ever get to. And whenever you go to the last horse, it goes transfers out of that container and appears to be in the horse. I'm not going to be abusing this that much. It's up to you what you call abusing, but if I have something, if I'm weighed down, I'm just going to put it in the horse. I'm not going to all of a sudden be picking up everything, because technically you could pick up anything and put it in the horse, and it's not realistic, though. Followers of form the Delta. Mounted combat. Okay, the charge is interesting. So the inventory on, yeah. Just in case, followers horses. If I get a follower again, and they don't die right away. Now, I assume you can use this without these mods. This is Ultimate Follower Overhaul, and these are two other mods I don't use. Choose horse management method. Followers are forced to ride regardless of combat and are invulnerable while the player is mounted. That's unrealistic. I'm going to turn that off. Horse skins. Global. Okay. So all followers have a Palomino horse. And what happens is you just, when they're ready to ride, you can just summon a horse and it appears out of nowhere. Which I know is unrealistic, but they run off a lot. And I've seen them, run off in people's Let's Plays and stuff like that. So I got fast dismount. Now I thought when I... Okay. I think in combat I will automatically just be armed. And at least I stay armed there. I can't go in first person mode. So if you charge at something, you basically can ram it with the horse. And it's odd. You can't... I could have sworn you could go into first person mode when on a horse. Ready there, Moosey? Let me watch this. Oh, it didn't work. I think it can't be running away from you or attacking you. Something like that. Oh, the horse runs out of stamina. I'm bummed it won't work. Yeah, I was sending things flying up into the sky, but it's not working now. Well, You can talk to people when you're on the horse using this. You can collect ingredients. Ah, what a bummer. Alright, so where's some ingredients? I haven't gotten this to work either. I'm not sure. I don't even know how to get into the horse's inventory. So, it's that you have to read the file. It's not really, like, user-friendly in that you can just do whatever. Yeah, it's not gonna work. For some reason. Horse is tired, or it's actively running away from me. So I guess you can only do it when you surprise things. Oh no. I almost fell in that hole. Tough terrain here. Where you going? You running away? So it... Yeah, it takes a little to get used to combat on this. Because you're attacking from the side. See, I'm fighting on that side. Which isn't... he's not on that side, so... it can be tough. Let me just get away and turn around. I gotta put the horse, the wolf, on the side that I'm on. So this is the new 1.6 version. I don't know why he runs away. Anyway. I'm supposed to be able to collect things. Ingredients. That, and I have to look up how to get into its inventory. This is my inventory, obviously. I don't know. Maybe it's that multi-tap thing. I have to click a certain amount of times to get into that. Stop that. I keep arming and disarming myself. I was just trying to charge him. Because obviously they're not suspecting. They're not running. Watch this then. Nope. Nothing. Just looking... Inventory transfers. Yeah. They could say here how exactly to do that. I guess it's the multi-tap thing. Control settings. Okay, double tap dismounted. Horse inventory. So... I don't want to hit the horse. Yeah, it's not working. Let's double with the activate. There it is. So I can give the horse things like that. So it's the activate key, or E, or whatever you use. I use delete key for that. Triple tap, multi-tap, talk, loot, okay. So I don't know what that means. Multi-tap, maybe just any, I don't know, double tap or more. That's when you're mounted. So then you could collect things.
Yes.
Whoops, didn't mean to do that. I didn't mean to do that either. It's going to take some use.
Oh, did you need something?
Getting used to. Yeah, I'm trying to talk to you guys while on the horse. It's interesting. Yeah, that's not what I wanted to do. So say if I want to collect the cabbage behind me.
Eye on the Pelagian. I had my years of war and fighting. Senseless. All of it. Need something?
See, you don't target, really. You just... You can talk to people, though.
Yes.
See, I'm not trying to talk to them right now. Oops, I dropped myself off. I want to see if I can collect these cabbage. No. Let's go to somewhere where people aren't and try to collect these things. Oh, nice. So everything in a certain radius. Cool. So I'm figuring this out, right, as I'm talking to you guys. So what I'm going to do now that I'm done messing around, I'm going to go to Morthal, and we're going to do this investigate the Gauldur legend. Started that, I'm not sure where I was to begin with. Maybe it was Hamver's Rest? Oh no, it was over here by Rorikstad. Yeah, started in Gearman's Hall and got this letter. I found this letter on a named undead that we found there. Wish I could get in first person mode.
Day with you around.
Oh, thank you, Katie. I'm gonna get off here. You should be fine here. If not, I'll blow the horn. I think if your horse dies also, you can If you blow the horn, a new one will appear. It's snowy out. And it's late, so I'm gonna sleep.
There ain't much to offer. Sure thing. It's yours for a day. I'll show you to your room. Right this way.
I know where it is. The coin purse isn't there.
Let me know if there's anything else you need.
Yeah. Good 8 hours. And we'll head out. We've almost reached. We're 25 minutes already.
To offer, but if you want a place dry to spend the night, I'll rent you a room.
I know, I just woke up from spending the night. Okay. So, the northwest.
My mother and father died years ago. Valiant takes care of me now.
That's good. I'm gonna go ride my horsey now. Let's see how he does in this water. I'm probably gonna get off this thing. See, for some reason now I'm trying to draw my weapon and it's not working. Oh, because I don't have one? Come on! Come on, spiders. Wow, big one. So, there's a little one. That's the same one. Empty, empty. Alright, never mind. Okay, now it's working. Because I didn't have one equipped, I guess you can't just pull out your bare hand. Alright, you're gonna stay here. You can actually hide over here. That the arrow's pointing right here. Danis Valen's journal. 18th of Morning Star, 4E201. How long has it been since I first heard? Those words are in the way. The Gauldur legend. 80 years? 100? I can think of nothing else now. My goal is at hand. After years of searching, I finally traced the ivory claw. How many claws are there? To a collector in Bravel. His death was necessary, but I have it. At last, I have it. 22nd and Morningstar 4E201. 3 days of non-stop riding, I reached Anvil ahead of my pursuers and took passage on the Ice Runner, bound for Solitude once more. 29th of Morningstar. The other passengers are becoming suspicious. Returning from dinner, I caught one brute rooting around in my quarters. He almost found the claw. Had the captain not intervened, I would have flayed him alive. I hope to spend the voyage sequestered in my room, reviewing my notes and preparing spells, but I need to deflect some attention from myself. I'll have to mingle, pretend to be just another petty mage for now. 2nd of Sun's Dawn. The brute claims to be an adventurer, off to seek his fortune in the ruins of Skyrim with his companions. Perhaps I can turn this to my advantage and use them as fodder for the traps and draugr within the tombs. I can just see the greed in his eyes. Yes, that should work. 3 weeks of Solitude, the captain says. I'll have to suffer these fools longer than that. I'll swim. Oh, if I have to suffer these fools longer than that, I'll swim. 27th of Sun's Dawn. With the brute and his companions in tow, I led our band across the march to Folgunthur, where we made camp for the night. Little has changed since my first expedition 10 years ago, but this time I have the claw, and I will have the amulet. I spent all night preparing a synopsis of my notes in case some fragment of the tale or piece of ancient lore may be needed to bypass the wards within a tomb. Then I cast all my books and scrolls into the fire and reduced my life's work to ashes. At long last, today is a day of reckoning. If I cannot have the amulet, no one will. Yeah? We'll see about that. So no one's here. They all went inside, I guess. No one keeping watch? These guys always keep watch. Alright then. Ooh. Folgunthur discovered. What's that? Oh, more fungal pods. I forgot about those. Blue... Purple poison. Blue baron. Trying to get them. I'm clicking the wrong thing. Oh. Gotcha. I don't think I've seen one of those before. Kinda cold for butterflies to be out. Oops. Greater Soul Gem. They at least leave this stuff laying out. Greater Soul Gem. It's amazing. These guys just leave gold and stuff all over the place. I'm the only one willing to search a burial urn. Wow. All right. Well. Well, I guess it's good to switch to a new episode. Yep. Thanks for watching, guys. Of course, next time that you see me, I'll be heading into Folgunthur. Thanks for watching again, and this is Nordpudding.